So this will be my final prediction for this upcoming fight between Jarrell, Big Baby, everybody's ducking in Miller, versus Marius Wach. Now, I'm going to tell you right now, this is going to be a sad fight. You're going to see Marius Wach get the living crap beat out of him. He's going to lose every single round. He's going to lose every single round. He's going to get walked down, and he's going to take an hellacious beating. He's going to get wilted, and you're probably going to see the referee stop the fight or his corner throw in the towel. That's what's going to happen. This fight's happening in Brooklyn. I like Marius Wach. I do. If I called him Marius Brutus, I'm sorry, but I like Marius Wach. But Marius Wach is, you know, 38 years old. Jarrell Miller is about 10 years younger than him. He's way more active than him, and he's way more in his prime and way more ambition. And really, like, everything is going for Jarrell Big Baby Miller. Marius Wach has always been known for having a great chin. Guys like Alexander Povetkin couldn't stop him. I mean, he stopped him, but he stopped him on his feet. That fight could have gone the distance, but the referee decided to stop it in round 12. Had he just let it continue 30 seconds on, he would have gone the distance with Alexander Povetkin. He also took everything but the kitchen sink against Vladimir Klitschko. But I think at this stage of his career, even though Jarrell Miller is not a one-punch devastating knockout puncher, he's a good inside fighter. And most guys that fight Marius Wach, they don't go to his body. When Alexander Povetkin and when Vladimir Klitschko fought him, they were all going to his head. They were throwing headshots. Vladimir Klitschko was throwing that jab and throwing that straight right hand down the pipe. Alexander Povetkin was leaping forward, throwing hooks. Everybody was going to his head. Had he fought, if you remember earlier this year, Marius Wach was going to fight, Dillian White. Had he fought Dillian White would have gone the distance with Marius Wach, because Dillian White would have been throwing those wild left hooks to Marius Wach's face, and Marius Wach would have been able to take everything but the kitchen sink by him and gone the distance. But unlike all these guys, Jarrell Big Baby Miller is actually a pretty good inside fighter. And he's going to be going, marching forward against Marius Wach with a high guard, but he's going to be throwing hooks to the body. And he's going to be hurting and chopping down Marius Wach's body. Because most, like I said, most fighters, they just go for the headshots. So they only focus on his head. And since he has such a granite chin, he's able to take all these punches because he has phenomenal chin. Even though he's a tall guy, he doesn't fight like a tall guy. You know, you don't see him popping that jab. He kind of comes forward. He is a decent puncher at heavyweight, but nothing special himself. But I think Marius Wach is going to be broken down with body shots. And that's why I say I think they're going to stop it with the corner or something. Or the ref might stop it, because he's probably going to get stopped with a body shot. And you're going to see him fall or like go on his knees from body punches. And he might be the very first guy to beat Marius Wach. I'll tell you one thing. If he is the first guy to stop Marius Wach, that would be very impressive, because no one has been able to do it. Alexander Povetkin, like I said, that fight could have gone the distance. It was the referee who stopped it. Or I believe it was at the corner, if I'm not mistaken. It's been a while since I've seen that fight. But Vladimir Klitschko is going to stop him. So if a prospect, because if you think about it, what's his name? Jarrell Big Baby Miller is really a prospect. The guy only has, 19 fights? So he's really a prospect, technically. I mean, because when Erickson Lubin, when he fought Jermall Charlo, he had the same amount of fights that Jarrell Miller has right now. He had like 18, 19 fights, and everybody was saying he's too green. He's a prospect. They were calling him a prospect. Remember that? So I would imagine you guys would also think that Jarrell Miller is a prospect, considering the fact that he also has the same amount of fights that Erickson Lubin has, 18 fights. He's just, a couple of years older? Like, I think he's 7 years older, but he still has the same type of amounts of fights. And that's why I respect him way more than someone like Wilder, because, you know, he's putting in the work earlier in his career. He's not waiting, 20 fights down the road. There's been rumors to say the winner of this fight will get Anthony Joshua. That would be amazing. You know I gotta represent my Brooklyn. And if that fight happens, you know I'm gonna go hard for Jarrell Big Baby Miller. I ain't going to be going hard for no Anthony Joshua if Jarrell Miller faces Anthony Joshua, because Jarrell Miller's from Brooklyn, so I got to represent Brooklyn. That's how it is. But this is going to be an hellacious beating. Again, I like Marius Walker. You know, he's always been a very humble type of guy. But I don't think it's... I think he's a little bit at the end of his career at this point. And I just think because everyone is always going for his body, you know, I mean, for his face to knock him out with hooks, I think he's going to be surprised when someone's going to his body. And maybe he doesn't have the conditioning on his body to go to be able to sustain these hooks. And I'm telling you right now, he will get stopped. And it's going to look like a statement. This is one of Eddie Hearn's cards in America. It seems to be a pretty good card. I mean, this is a decent fight. Marius Walk versus Jarrell Miller. And even the main event, which is Daniel Jacobs versus Luis Arias. But I definitely predict both Daniel Jacobs, the two Brooklyn boys, both Daniel Jacobs and Jarrell Miller to definitely win these fights. That's all I have to say, guys. Please like the video. Please thumbs up the video. Please let me know your comments. And McGregor's out, guys.